DaVinci Resolve 20 is here, and in this video, I'm going to be sharing with you five of the biggest updates for wedding filmmakers. So yes, if you edit wedding videos, this video is for you. But even if you don't, I'm sure you're going to be able to use these features if you edit corporate or commercial videos, documentaries, interviews, etc. And in addition, if you need help editing your wedding videos or photos, I would highly recommend reaching out to my friends and the sponsors of this video, Bride and Groom Video. I've been using Bride and Groom Video to edit my wedding films and YouTube videos, and I love them because they can edit your videos incredibly quickly for a shockingly cheap price. Seriously, they have a 2-week turnaround time. You can get your edits back in 14 days. I have a friend who used them a few weeks ago, and he was blown away by how good the edits that he got from them were. See, when it comes to editing, Bride and Groom truly care about matching your unique video editing style, and they're very upfront that if you need changes, they're happy to keep making revisions until you are 100% happy. Plus, Bride and Groom's website has a super simple and convenient online interface that they're constantly updating. You can log in anytime and submit new films for editing or check on the status of your existing films. Look, we are over halfway through the year at this point, and in my experience, we as filmmakers and editors always get busy in the lead up to Christmas. The backlog starts to fill up. So now is the time to reach out to Bride and Groom. You can sign up and tell them your schedule of wedding films coming in the next 6 months, and they will be ready to edit them as fast as you can film them. And when you reach out today using my sign up link in the video description to book Bride and Groom for your wedding photo or video editing, you can use the coupon code MAT100 to get $100 off your first edit of $400 or more. So sign up today. Anyways, let's talk about DaVinci Resolve 20 updates that are going to blow your mind if you edit wedding films. Up first, one of my favorite new DaVinci Resolve features has to do with audio. And the reason that I love this new tool is that it takes a traditionally rather complicated workflow and uses AI to make it dramatically simpler while giving you professional level results. This new tool is called the Audio Assistant. And if you've ever edited a video before, I'm sure you're probably aware that the sound in your video is going to need to be mixed. And this is something that usually you have to do by hand, with you playing through your video and adjusting your sound levels to make sure they sound their best, adding different effects to boost anyone speaking, adjusting music volume so it isn't too loud. You know, sound mixing. And like I said, this has traditionally been very complicated, especially if you're editing a wedding film, because you have to know how all these tools work, you have to know what sounds good, and more than that, you're commonly going to find yourself dealing with a ton of different sources of audio. You have microphones on a ton of people on the wedding day, a sound recorder plugged into the soundboard. I commonly find myself recording 5 or 6 sources of audio for a wedding ceremony at minimum, and whenever you have all these audio tracks and you import them into DaVinci Resolve, it can be a big pain to get your video sounding as good as you need it to. Thankfully, that's where the new Audio Assistant tool comes in, because it excels at very large, complicated video projects like a wedding. And instead of needing to go through the rigorous mixing process like usual, you just click a button and let AI and DaVinci Resolve analyze all of your audio and mix it for you in less than a minute. This is the potential to make your life dramatically easier and help you edit videos significantly faster. If you want to see a full tutorial about how to use this tool in depth in the future, please subscribe and I will work on it. Next, let's talk about one of the most mind-blowing updates in DaVinci Resolve 20. Like, it doesn't feel like this update should even be possible. It is so insane. Here's the scenario. You're filming a wedding and the groom has written a letter to his bride, but he misspeaks as he's reading the letter and he says the wrong thing.
I love your determination and your self-discipline and even your work ethic.
Did you hear that mistake? It's at this point that you as a video editor have an issue, because if this line that's being spoken is critical to the story that you're trying to tell, you either need to track down the person and ask them to record that line again somehow, or do major video editing surgery where you cut up other lines that the person has said and use individual words and sounds to create the sentence that they should have said correctly in the first place. I've done it before, and let me tell you, neither of these options are great. They're both going to take you a ton of work, so what if there was a better way? What if you could make the person speaking in your video say the exact words that they meant to say, and you could do it with a very minimal amount of work, the vast amount of which is going to occur in the background while you keep editing as normal? That's where this new tool called AI Voice Convert in DaVinci Resolve comes in. All you have to do is use some existing audio of the person speaking to create a clone of their voice. Then you re-record yourself reading the line, just like I have done here. Hey, this is Matt, and this is my normal voice. But let's change that.
Hey, I'm Paul, and let's fix that line that I messed up. I love your determination and your self-discipline and your work ethic.
And you can then convert your voice into the voice of the person that was speaking using the voice clone tool. This is so crazy and it works so well. We as editors can finally fix and help our clients say what they were trying to say and make our videos even clearer and our stories stronger. If you want to learn more about this voice cloning tool in particular, I've already created an in-depth tutorial showing you exactly how to use it with very easy to follow steps. I'll link it up in the corner and down in the video description. Up next, we have a feature that I've been desperately waiting for Blackmagic to copy and take from Adobe, and this is the AI Music Editor. The way this tool works is instead of you needing to go through the hassle of adjusting the length of a song that you want to use in your video, you'd usually do this by duplicating the track, then mixing different parts together to make it longer or shorter. Instead, you can now just let AI and this music remix tool do it for you. All you have to do is select your song that you want to change the length of, go over here to the inspector and down to AI Music Editor. And here you can choose the exact target length that you want your song to be extended or shortened to, or what I prefer is to check this live trim box. Then go down here to the audio, go to the end, drag it out so it's the proper length that you want, wait for DaVinci Resolve to analyze the clip for a few seconds, and just like that, your song will then be remixed to the proper length, and you can see where the song was cut with these squiggly lines here. Otherwise, that is done. Now, if you edit in Premiere Pro, you're probably thinking, come on, Matt, this tool has been in Premiere for years, but hold up, because Blackmagic has improved on it. So you can go through all these different versions, demo them, and choose the one that you like best for your edit. I am so glad to see this tool in Resolve, because I use it all the time to adjust the length of my songs and my videos in Premiere Pro, and now I can do it in DaVinci Resolve too. This is a huge time saver, and I think you're going to absolutely love it. Now, let's head over to the cut page, and I'm sure you're thinking, really, Matt, the cut page? Does anyone actually even use that page? Well, hold up, because this DaVinci Resolve 20 update may give you a reason to. One thing that I'm sure you probably find yourself doing all the time if you're editing videos for your clients is making vertical edits for Instagram and TikTok, because even if you're creating full-length, horizontal, traditional wedding films, your couple is inevitably going to want some vertical videos to put on their social media too. That's where the new vertical video viewer in DaVinci Resolve 20 comes in, because you're no longer limited to being stuck with a horizontal video preview, even though you're editing a vertical video. No, Blackmagic was really smart, and now if you create a vertical timeline like I have here, you're able to go over here and press this expand button, and just like that, this is going to give you a vertical preview window that will show your video natively without trying to shove it into a horizontal space. This works so well, it looks so good, and it may actually give you a reason to learn how to use the cut page. Maybe. Last but definitely not least, a couple years ago, a plugin called Autopod took the video editing world by storm because it used AI to automatically edit any long form YouTube video like a podcast in seconds instead of the minutes or hours they would commonly take you to edit by hand. This tool would cut between camera angles depending on who was speaking, and overall, it did a really great job. It was also really versatile with capabilities that extended far beyond podcasts. And I even created a video demonstrating how you could use this tool to edit long form wedding ceremony videos, properly cutting between people speaking and saving yourself a ton of time thanks to AI. This tool, of course, though, had two cons, one of which is completely understandable. It wasn't free. You had to pay a monthly subscription for it, which I still hold is completely worth it. But the second issue was something that will directly affect you if you edit in DaVinci Resolve. And that issue is that this tool did not support DaVinci Resolve. It only worked for Premiere Pro. Well, speaking of DaVinci Resolve, now that we've set the stage with this cool Autopod tool, it looks like Blackmagic was not content to wait for them to eventually release a version for DaVinci at all. No, instead, Blackmagic just created their own version of this tool that works incredibly similarly, even better, and it's now included for free in the DaVinci Resolve Studio 20 update, meaning that you can now import your podcasts or wedding ceremonies or anything long form that has multiple camera angles, and Resolve will automatically go through your video using AI to make cuts between different camera angles. And did I mention there's a free update? It's awesome. All you have to do is import your video footage like I have from a wedding ceremony here, create a multi-cam sequence from it, right-click on the sequence, select multi-cam smart switch. I would select no wide angle, choose better for quality, and click analyze. DaVinci Resolve will then analyze your video's audio to determine who is speaking, as well as look at the lips of people, which is something an Autopod cannot do, and then it will automatically generate multi-cam cuts for you between all of these angles. This has the potential to save you so much time in your video editing. You got to check out this AI multicam smart switch tool. And those are, in my opinion, the top five tools that Blackmagic has added to DaVinci Resolve 20 to help you edit better wedding films even faster. Of course, these tools can be used for editing other videos as well, but if you're a wedding filmmaker like me, I think you're going to be really impressed by these in particular. That said, if you're looking at your backlog of videos and you're thinking, Matt, I do not have enough time to get through all these, even with these cool tools, that is where I would highly recommend you reach out to my friends at Bride and Groom Video. They would love to help you edit your wedding videos. And like I said, I had a friend use them a few weeks ago, and he said that the edits they made for him turned out great. I'll link to Bride and Groom Video down in the video description, and I'll also link down there to my edit videos like a pro guide. This guide is going to show you some of the most important tips that took me years to learn as a video editor and will apply to you regardless of whether you're editing in DaVinci Resolve, Final Cut Pro, Premiere Pro, etc. This guide is completely free. And with that, thank you so much for watching. Please like this video and subscribe if you'd like to see more videos about video editing and DaVinci Resolve and filmmaking in the future, and have a great day.